Do you think you have the right support in the cabinet, within the government, yeah, civil service?
Well, the cabinet is very supportive, I must say, that when there is a difference among the ministers, they go according to my views, because they want to be united, they don't want to break up. For example, when I suggested that there should be a vote, because there were two differing opinions in the cabinet, they said no, no vote. I say, if you don't have a vote, how do you decide which one? So we go according to what you say. Yeah. So there is quite good loyalty there.
What about the fact that some of them say that you have brought the old and very experienced, you know, who used to be with you when you were the fourth prime minister, and then they seem to have a bigger say in some of the things?
That may be the impression, but the thing is that I have to listen to differing views and I make the decision. Of course, people with experience are very important, but the new people are learning very quickly.
You said you don't have much time and you are rushing.
Well, I would like to have a lot of time, but they come and see me quite often. Even this morning, Mat Sabu came to see me to see what to help him make a decision. But all the others know that at any time at all they want to see me, I never reject. I give priority to the ministers, you know, and I listen to their problems and help to resolve most of them.
But some of them seem to have flip-flopped here and there, then you get bad press. What is your advice?
Because some of them are lacking in experience as ministers, I need to spend more time in explaining. For example, we decided when we took over that we will stop all contracts. But when you stop the contracts, the economy doesn't move.
Correct.
You see, a big chunk of the economy doesn't move, and that does not help the economy. We should have, we had frozen some accounts and all that. We should immediately deal with the problem and make a decision. But sometimes because of probably lack of experience, it took us quite a bit of time to make a decision. For example, before all contracts were given out on negotiated tender, and you stop them from working because you think that the contracts were not well worked out, but you stop too long, then they cannot move, the economy doesn't move, especially when you freeze their accounts, they cannot do anything, and if they don't, this chunk of the, this part of the national economy is delayed.
Inexperience, the lack of experience on the part of your ministers, many people feel that the burden has to fall on you to run the country by yourself. Do you feel the burden?
Yeah, when they are unsure about anything, they do come to me because they know I had experience, 22 years as Prime Minister. Then I would be able to advise them as to what to do. But of course, the burden is heavy, because what I'm doing now is three times more than what I did when I became Prime Minister for the first time. I have to work the whole day, even if they don't disturb me. There are so many problems to be resolved, and some of my ministers are not familiar enough with the problem. They cannot solve, so they come to me. So the burden of work, I agree, is very heavy. I can't read some letters written to me. I could only read 3 months later. And then I find that what they asked for, has the date has already passed. People ask me why I don't respond. The fact is that I try to respond, but I can't finish my work. You see? Even, you know, at night there are people who come to see me, or I had to attend something or other. which means that I don't have time to implement. Mm-hmm. I know what should be done. In one day, somebody dumps on my desk 5 different problems, which needs my time. But I don't have that time. People come endlessly. They come to see me, and they overstay. And because of that, I cannot go home. So I have to work until 6, 7 o'clock. And at home, I go back, I still find people in the house wanting me to do something.